Morning! Magandang umaga po sa ating lahat as we celebrate our 12th anniversary, our UCO Ministries Home of Christ. Inayayahan ko po ang bawat isa, tayo po'y lahat tumayo. Let's all stand at sabay-sabay nga po natin isigaw ito. Happy 12th anniversary, Home of Christ, UCO Ministries! Sama po ng buong kagalakan po let's all lahat po tayo tayo ay 1, 2, 3 go. Happy 12th anniversary Home of Christ UCO Ministries. Tayo po ba'y pinagpala? Amen. We are all blessed people ba? Let us clap our hands, let us sing our praises sa ating Panginoon, because our God is great and He is worthy of our praise. Amen. when surrounded. Cause praise is the waters, my enemies drowning. As long as I'm breathing, I've got a reason to praise the Lord, oh my soul. Praise the Lord, oh my soul. A praise in the valley, praise on the mountain, yes, Lord. A praise when I'm sure, praise when I'm doubting. A praise when I'm covered, praise when surrounded. Cause praise is the waters, my enemies drowning. As long as I'm breathing, I've got a reason to praise the Lord, oh my soul. Praise the Lord, oh my soul. I won't be quiet, my God is alive. Praise when I feel it, I praise when I don't. I praise cause I know you're still in control. Yes, Lord, you are. My praise is a weapon, it's more than a sound. My praise is the shout that brings Jericho down. Praise is a weapon, it's more than sound. My praise is the shout that brings Jericho down. As long as I'm breathing, I've got a reason to praise the Lord, oh my soul. Praise cause you're sovereign, praise cause you reign, praise cause you rose and defeated the grave. I'll praise cause you're faithful, praise cause you're true, praise cause there's nobody greater than you. I praise cause you're sovereign, praise cause you reign, praise cause you rose and defeated the grave. I'll praise cause you're faithful, praise cause you're true. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. us, Lord, Lord God. Let us praise His name. Hallelujah. Let's open our mouths. Let's praise His name. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. Maraming salamat, Panginoon, Lord. Tunay nga pong napakabuti niyo, Panginoon, at napakadakila ninyo sa aming buhay, Lord Jesus. You have done so many great things in our lives, in this church, Lord Father God, Lord. Wala po kapantayan ang inyong pagmamahal sa bawat isa po sa amin, Lord God. And we're here, Lord Father God, Lord, para po ibigay ang aming awit, Panginoon, sa inyo. Awit ng papurit, pasasalamat, Lord, at pagsamba for who you are, Lord. We worship you for who you are, Lord God. You are the great I am. You are our Savior, Lord Jesus. We love you, Lord. He's the Lord and most worthy of praise. The city of our God, the holy place. The joy of the whole earth. The Lord in whom we have the victory. He aids us against the enemy. We bow down on And sisters, let us close our eyes. Let's come before our Lord God with a humble heart, with hearts full of thanksgiving sa ating Panginoon. Pasalamatan natin ating Panginoon dahil siya po'y dakila at totoo tapat sa kanyang mga salita. There is no God who is like Him. Let us open our mouths. Let us come and pray. Lord Jesus, aming Panginoon, Lord, You are the Lord of Lords. Kayo lamang po ang aming sasambahin, Panginoon. Pupurihin sa lahat ng inyong mga ginagawa, Panginoon, Lord. You alone is our great God, Lord. Kami po hindi magsasawa, Panginoon, na umawit at purihin ka, Lord God. Because You are worthy, Lord. Worthy of our praise, Lord Jesus. You are so, so good, Lord, to every one of us, Lord. We love You, Lord Jesus. I love You, Lord. Oh, Your mercy never fails me. All my days I've been held in Your hand. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, I will sing of the goodness of God. All my life You have been faithful. All my of the goodness of God. Ang piling mo siyang gabay ka sa kasakitan, at nariyan ka sa gitna ng kadiliman. Ika'y aking kaibigan, O Diyos aking Ama. Ako'y buhay sa kabutihan ng Diyos. Ika'y tapat sa habang buhay. Ika'y mabuti magpakailanman hanggat ako ay nabubuhay. Kabutihan ng Diyos. Ang tinig mo, Panginoon, tinig mo siyang gabay sa kasakitan, at nariyan ka sa gitna ng kadiliman. Ika'y aking kaibigan,
O Diyos aking Ama, at ako'y buhay sa kabutihan ng Diyos. Ika'y tapat sa habang buhay, ika'y mabuti magpakailanman hanggat ako ay nabubuhay. Aawitin ko ang kabutihan ng Diyos. Ika'y kabutihan ng Diyos. Ika'y tapat, Panginoon. Ika'y tapat sa habang buhay, ika'y mabuti magpakailanman hanggat ako ay nabubuhay. Aawitin kabutihan ng Diyos. Aawitin ko ang kabutihan ng Diyos. Aawitin ko ang kabutihan ng Diyos. Aawitin ko ang kabutihan ng Diyos.
Yes, Lord Jesus. Indeed, in Psalms 104, verse 33 says, I will sing to the Lord all my life. As long as I live, I will sing praises to my God. Yes, Lord, Panginoon, Lord. Maraming salamat, Lord, sa iyong kabutihan, Lord. Lord, maraming salamat, Panginoon, sa araw-araw na nariyan ka para sa amin, Panginoon, Lord. We as your children, Lord. Patuloy po namin kayo pupurihin, Panginoon, Lord, sa lahat po ng inyong ginagawa sa aming buhay, Lord, dahil kayo'y tapat, Lord, at kayo'y may buti, Lord Jesus. Maraming salamat, Lord. May our lives to our Lord continue to reflect, Lord, your glory, Lord, ng maraming tao, Panginoon, nang makakita sa inyo, Panginoon, Lord, at purihin din kayo, Panginoon, Lord Jesus. We love you, Lord God, Lord. We continue to praise your name, Lord, in this place. Hallelujah, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, amen.
You may take your seats. Okay, welcome you brothers and sisters, friends who have joined us for the first time. Okay, we are here to celebrate our 12th anniversary. Okay, we are constantly reminded of the goodness of God, and we would like to share His goodness with you also. Okay, I don't know how you are doing with your life right now. Okay, if you are following the news, alam natin na bugulo ang mundo. Okay, there is war everywhere. There is war still between Russia and Ukraine. There is war with Israel and her neighbors. Okay, and even in our own country, the Philippines, magulo din, di ba? Gulo ba? Yes, well, at least I still follow the news in the Philippines, medyo magulo din. Okay, and here in Taiwan, marami din yung problema. So, everywhere in the world, we see chaos, instability, insecurity. But we believe in the one true God who can give us the peace in spite of all of these things. And like invite you today to learn about this God, okay, to be acquainted with Him, para like us, you may have His peace also, and that you may join this family and share in His blessings. Okay, and it is our hope that during this time, as we listen to His word, that He would speak to you personally. Okay, it will address your personal problems, personal difficulties, or challenges, and that God may give you peace.
Good morning, brothers and sisters. Today we are celebrating our 12th anniversary. Okay. You know, God established itong church na to in September 9, 2012, we started this church. But before we started our first worship celebration, we gathered together as a church. Actually, we had been meeting for, before that, 3 years before that. So, masasabi natin is in 2009, okay, we started to be here gathering together in a cell group. And then in 2012, okay, we started our worship celebration. Okay, so, I believe that in these 12 years, okay, that you have been in the church, all of us had experienced the blessing of God, the goodness of God, hindi ba? In different ways, I believe that. And this morning, before I go to the passage, the message, I would like to ask a sister, okay, one of our sister, to share with us, okay, yung blessing that God has brought upon her life. Okay, we would like to ask si Sonia Maramba to come forward, please, and to share with us, okay, how God has been good, okay, and how God has blessed her.
Good morning po sa ating lahat, my brothers and sisters in Christ po. Una, nais ko pong bumati ng happy 12 years anniversary Home of Christ Church at sa ating lahat po na naririto po. Salamat po sa Panginoon sa paggamit po ng church na to sa mga manggagawa at sa mga naririto po sa ating lahat po. Salamat sa Panginoon at hinayaan niya akong makatayo sa inyong harapan upang maitaas at mapurihan ang kanyang pangalan. Amen. Ginakapan. Nais ko pong ibahagi ang kwento ng buhay ko, kung paano ko po nakilala ang Panginoon at kung paano niya ako binago sa kabila ng aking lahat ng pagkukulang. Lumaki po ako sa simpleng pamumuhay at namulat po sa ibang paniniwala. Naakala ko dati, ang pagiging mabuti at walang tinatapakang tao ay sapat na upang maligtas po. Sorry, meron po. Ngunit hindi po pala maliligtas ang isang tao sa sarili lamang gawa o kabutihan po. Naging easy lang din po ang pamumuhay ko noon. Magsisimba lang ako kung gusto ko lang. Aminado din po ako na pati po pagbabasa ng Bible ay hindi ko po nagagawa. Pero alam ko po sa sarili ko na may Diyos, pero yung will niya sa buhay ko ay hindi ko po nasusunod or maaring hindi ko po talaga alam kung ano ba ang nais ng Diyos sa aking buhay. Ang alam ko lang talaga ay kailangan kong makapagtapos ng pag-aaral para po makahanap po ng maayos na trabaho at makatulong sa aking pamilya dahil sa hirap po ng buhay. Pero kahit ganun po ang aking pananaw sa buhay, alam ko na di po ako pinabayaan ng Diyos hanggang dumating ang araw na ako po ay nakapagtapos po ng pag-aaral. Sa awa po ng Diyos, ako po ay nakahanap agad ng trabaho. Year 2014 po, masaya ko pong ako'y makakapagtrabaho na po. Sa unang trabaho ko po sa hospital bilang cook attendant, sa unang trabahong yon, may nakatrabaho po akong isang Christian po na nakapagbahagi po sa akin ng salita ng Diyos at naging kaibigan po. Nakita ko na lagi silang nagsisimba at ako'y kanyang inangyayahan po sa kanilang church at ako naman po ay sumama sa kanila. Naging sa aking pagsasama at pakikinig ay doon ko po lubos na nakilala ang Diyos, ang Panginoong Hesukristo sa aking buhay. At ang kasiyahan at kabutihan ng tao na sumasampalatay sa Diyos. At ako nga po ay tumanggap sa Panginoon. Sa ngayon po, masaya ko pong sabihin sa inyo na yung kasabay kong na-hired sa trabaho at yung dahilan kung bakit po ako naging Kristiyano yung ngayon, ay siya na rin po ang katuwang ko sa buhay. Kinasal po kami taong 2019 po. Bilang buhay mag-asawa, dumaan din po kami sa iba't ibang pagsubok po at hamon ng buhay. Tulad na lamang po nang malayo po kami sa isa't isa pagkat pinili niya pong magtrabaho dito sa Taiwan po. Pero hindi po yung dahilan para masira kami, kundi mas lalong kaming lumalim at tumibay sa relasyon po naming mag-asawa. Higit sa lahat, nagkaroon po kami ng mas malalim sa pananampalataya at natuto kaming magtiwala sa Panginoon po. Sabi po sa James 1:12-13, happy are those who remain faithful under trials, because when they succeed in passing such a test, they will receive the reward which God has promised to those who love Him po. Amen. Sa grasya po ng Panginoon at sa tulong ni Ate Gina at Ate Dayan na ginamit ng Diyos, ako po ay nakabalik dito sa Taiwan at nagkaroon po ng maayos na trabaho. At ngayon, kasama ko na po ang aking asawa at nagpupuri at nagpapasalamat po sa Panginoon po. Amen. Sa kabutihan niya po sa aking buhay. Sa ngayon po, 2 years na rin po ako dito sa Taiwan. At 2 years na rin po akong nagsisimba dito sa Home of Christ Church po. Malaking tulong po sa akin ang Home of Christ dahil linggo-linggo na rin po akong nakakasimba at nakakarinig ng Word of God. Dito po ako natutong magbuklat ng Bible, mag-LRT at mag-scripture memory po. At may mga cell group o matatawag po na pamilya. Dito nagkaroon po ako ng brothers and sisters in Christ na lagi pong andyan in times of problema, kung kailangan mo ng prayers, advice, especially tungkol sa spiritual health po. Sa Home of Christ, mas lalong lumalim po ang aking pananampalataya po. Sobrang pasasalamat ko ngayon kasi ramdam ko po na may Diyos akong buhay na kailanman hindi po ako binabayaan. Nalaman ko din po yung mga promises ni Lord sa akin na lagi ko pong pinanghahawakan po. Kaya lagi po akong nagpapatuloy at nagtitiwala sa Panginoon. At wala pong... Sorry. At nalaman ko din po ang kahalaga ng John 3:16 po na for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son so that whoever believes in Him may not die but have eternal life po. Ganun po tayo kamahal ng Diyos nang lumikha po sa atin na ibinigay niya po ang kanyang kaisa-isang anak upang kung sino man po lamang po ang sumampalatay sa kanya hindi po maligtas ay hindi po kung di po maliligtas. Para po sa akin po ang John 3:16 po ay pag-ibig na mula sa Diyos at kailangan din po nating share sa iba hindi lamang po sa pamilya kundi po sa nakakasalamuha po natin araw-araw po. Kaya hindi po ako magsasawang pasalamatan ng Diyos nating buhay po. May 7 po, 2013, last year, masaya ko din pong sabihin sa inyo na nabaptize po ako dito din po sa Home of Christ Church. Kaya gusto ko magpasalamat sa inyong lahat na narito po sa lahat ng boy sa Home of Christ Church, especially sa pastor mo natin na si Pastor Reverend Joseph Chowa po at sa pastora po natin na Pastora PB po at sa lahat po ng mga manggagawa dito sa church, sa mga leaders at sa mga cell group leaders po, especially po kay Deacon Jael po at Ate Gina po. Salamat sa inyong mga buhay at sa walang sawang pagtuturo at pag-encourage po sa amin. Salamat po sa inyong lahat. Dahil dyan po tunay na nakikita ang biyaya at pagmamahal ng Diyos sa inyong mga buhay po. Ako po ngayon ay hanggang ngayon po sinusubok pa rin po ng aking pananampalataya po. Marami pa rin po mga problema. Mga pagsubok po sa buhay po. Last May po, nabuntis po ako ng kambal. Pero hindi po nabuo sa aking tiyan po. Seven weeks po sila sa aking tiyan. Pero na-check po ng doktor na wala pong heartbeat. Kailangan pong alisin sa aking tiyan kasi baka daw pumalasan po ako. Wala po akong choice po, kundi sumunod po sa doktor. Wala po akong choice nun. Yun po yung pinakasobrang experience na naranasan ko sa aking buhay po. Wala pa akong choice kundi magtiwala pa din po ng buong buo sa Panginoon. Kasi yun naman po ang dapat. Walang makakatulong sa akin kundi ang Panginoon lamang. Kaya sa mga tulad ko po na nakakaranas po ng problema at sa hamon ng buhay po, huwag po tayong magsasawang manalangin po kasi mas malaki po ang Diyos po nating buhay kaysa sa lahat po ng problema na dumadaan po sa ating buhay. Sabi po sa Joshua 1:9, be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid or discouraged. For I, the Lord your God, I'm with you wherever you go po. Ako po si Sonia Maramba de Vera na hindi magsasamang magpupuri, magsaserve at magpapasalamat po sa kabutihan ng Diyos sa aking buhay. Wala po akong pwedeng ipangmayabang sa mundo kasi lahat ng meron po ako ay galing lamang po sa Diyos. Kung meron man po akong dapat ipangmayabang ay ang kabutihan at kadakilan ng aking Diyos po sa aking buhay. To God be all the glory and praise po. Amen.
Indeed, God is good, God is faithful, and God is great. Hindi ibig sabihin na, you know, when we have a God who is good, who is great, and who is faithful, na wala nang mga problema. But the fact is that we all go through problems in life, just like what the Bible said. Sabi ng Bible that in this world, there will always be trouble, there will be always tribulation. Marami yan, darating na darating. But be of good cheer because God has overcome the world. And in God, we could always overcome from one problem to another. That is why as we come to celebrate, not only we celebrate na lahat ng buhay natin is good, walang mga masasamang nangyayari, but rather we celebrate the goodness of God that in the midst of yung mga problema natin, God is still there. And I believe all of us have experienced God in our lives, no matter sa family natin, sa trabaho natin, sa health natin in every way. And in these past 12 years, God always show His faithfulness to us. And so how do we celebrate itong anniversary natin? It is not only for the leaders of the church, but for all of us because we belong to this church and we are the church. Okay, hindi building, but all of us who belong to God, we are the church. And so how do we celebrate the goodness of God this past 12 years? Okay. First, we celebrate it by giving thanks for all the blessing and goodness that God has shown us, that has given to us. Okay, just think about the first time that you came to church until today. Ano yung mga blessing na binigay ng Diyos sa atin? Now, these are all the things that we need to give thanks to the Lord. Okay. So, we come to Him, we give thanks, not only individually, as well as a church. Okay, we are here to give thanks. Second, how do we celebrate? By recommitting ourselves to God and to the ministry that He has given to us. You know, God bring us here not only for us to experience yung mga blessing niya, ganun na lang. Just like what si Sonia said, okay, John 3:16 is a love of God for us. And we need to share this love with other people. And God has given us a mission sa church natin. And that is to search for the lost and bring back the stray, to bind up the injured and strengthen the weak so that I, the Lord, will be their God. Now, this is the mission And this is the purpose that God has called us together. And so as we celebrate, not only we thank God for all the goodness, but we recommit and say to the Lord, Lord, here I am, use me. So that I would be able to help other people find God, okay, and that they will be able to experience the goodness of God. Thirdly, how do we celebrate? Not only we give thanks, not only we recommit ourselves, we move forward, okay, to the mission that God has given to us. Okay, and not only we know about it, but we all join in. Okay, kaya nga, there are times that we would have a lot of events at church natin, and we want to be used by God in bringing people so that they would be able to know God and experience God, especially in times that they are struggling and they need help. Okay, so may God help us and may God bless each one of us. So why not let us all stand up right now? Okay, let us all pray together. Okay, so as we celebrate itong tatlo na to, let us pray for these three things. First, pasalamatan natin ang Diyos for all the goodness, the blessing that He had bring upon us. Okay, upon our families, upon our children, sa work natin, sa health natin, in every way. Second, let us recommit our lives to the Lord. Okay, and said, Lord, here I am. I want, Lord, to live for you, and I want, Lord, that I would be continue to follow after you and to recommit to the missions and the visions that you have given to us. And thirdly, let us pray na, Lord, use me. Gamitin mo ako. Use me so that I would be able to become a blessing to other people, bringing people so that their lives would be different, just like what we have experienced, God. So, itong tatlo na to is what we want to pray, and it is where we celebrate the goodness of God. Why not let us all pray together? Let us bring glory to God. Let us pray, and let us come before the Lord. Let's all pray together right now. Father, we come to you, Lord. We thank you and we praise you, Lord, for your goodness, Lord, in our lives. Father, you have always been good, Lord. You have been always sustaining me, Lord, and using me, Lord, to become a blessing to a lot of people. And I find, Lord, purpose in my life. I find, Lord, the joy, Lord, in serving you and being with my brothers and sisters, seeing how you have been good, Lord, to them and how you have done, Lord, great things in their lives. Father, we continue, Lord, to pray that, Lord, hear my voice. Indeed, Lord, as we come to you, Lord, today, we thank you, Lord, for the goodness, the faithfulness, Lord, and the blessing that you have brought upon us, Lord, in every way. Lord, no matter it is a small things or big things, Lord, nothing, Lord, you never withhold good things from us, and we thank you, Lord. And at the same time, Lord, we want to commit ourselves to you right now, to follow after you, Lord, and Lord, to be able, Lord, to commit ourselves to you and to the mission that you have given to church. And at the same time, Lord, we want to say, here we are, Lord, use us, Lord, that our lives will become a beacon of hope, and as well as, Lord, a way, Lord, that would be able to bless other people, an instrument wherein people would be able to know you through us. And Lord, continue, Lord, to lead us and to send us out. Father, we thank you, Lord. This morning, we come to you acknowledging, Lord, that you are here and that your goodness continue to be with us. We thank you and we praise you, Lord. We give back all glory to you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen, Lord. Before you sit down, why not tell the person beside you, okay, sabi niyo sa kanya, be ablaze with the glory of God, arise and shine. Like, okay, please be seated. Okay, please be seated. Okay, so be ablaze with God's glory so that we would be able to arise and shine for God. Okay, this is the important of the church that God has given to us. Okay, you know, our church is now 12 years old. Okay, just imagine, if you have kids, di ba? Pag meron kayong mga anak, 12 years old, ano nang magiging hugis ng tao na yun, or what is this person become? Okay, you know, I remember Jesus, okay, in the Old New Testament. Okay, remind me of Jesus who went to with his parents to Jerusalem, okay, when he was 12 years old. Okay, and so he went there to celebrate the Passover feast. Okay, now on their way home, Okay. His parents thought that he was with other relatives. Kala niya nasa kasama niya yung mga relatives niya. But on the way, they realized that they could not find Jesus. So ang ginawa nila, bumalik na nga sila sa Jerusalem. And they went to the temple to look for Jesus. And what they saw, they were astonished because they saw Jesus sitting among the teachers of the law. Okay, mga Pharisees, mga teachers of law. And he was there listening as well as he was asking questions. And even those leaders, they were astonished as at the wisdom, okay, of Jesus. Okay. And so when they came to Jesus, Jesus said to them, ito yung sinabi ni Jesus sa kanila. He said, "Why did you have to look for me? Did not you know that I have to be in my Father's house?" Di nyo ba alam na kailangan ano, I should be in my Father's house. So after this incident, Jesus went back with his parents to Nazareth, okay, where he was obedient to his parents. And in Luke 2:52, ito yung sinabi niyan. Okay. Jesus grew in wisdom and maturity. He gained favor for God and people. Okay. So, he grew in wisdom and maturity. So, as we celebrate our 12th anniversary, 12 years na tayo. So, as a church, may God help us. And I pray that we would be able to grow in wisdom. Ano itong wisdom na sinasabi? Hindi yung matalino tayo sa labas. But wisdom comes from knowing Jesus and His Word. That give us the wisdom. Wisdom wherein we know how to deal with things. We know how to respond to our surrounding in a godly way. So may God give us wisdom as we read His Word, as we grow to maturity to be more and more like Him. And at the same time, we gain favor for God and people. Now, what does it mean by gain favor for God? That we are pleasing to God in every way. You know, God promised us, if we are pleasing to God, He will give us the desires of our heart. Yun ang promise niya sa atin. And not only gain favor for God, but for other people. Means to say, we need to live in peace and harmony with all the people around us. Hindi lang sa church, we are peaceful and in harmonious. But even in our work, even in our dorm, whenever we are with friends or we are with our mga kasama natin sa trabaho, we need to always live in peace and in harmony. So, learning how to love, learning how to be connected with them, okay, in life. And so may God help us that just like Jesus when he was 12 years old, tayo din, all of us, would be able to grow in wisdom and maturity and gain favor for God and people. Okay, may God help us. Now, last week, Saturday, now, some of you or most of you know that my son got married, okay? And it was a very joyful celebration for us as a church, for us, a family, and even our church because they know me and then they know, a lot of people know my son, okay? And so last Sunday, after yung kasal, the next Sunday, last Sunday, so one of our elders, a church leader sa church natin, now he came and he gave us an red envelope, which is tradition. Okay, when you have got married or birthday, di ba nagbibigyan ng red envelope? Okay, and so he gave an envelope through another person. Okay, binigay sa atin, and he wished us, our family and our son, okay, with joyful congratulation. Okay, and so we are happy that he, even though he was not able to come. Okay, so he said that hindi siya makapunta, but he was happy for us and he celebrated with us. Okay, so this is what happened Sunday. But after 3 days, Wednesday, okay, I received a message and was informed that yung wife niya, okay, died, okay, passed away. Just imagine, okay, 3 days before, okay, he was happy for us, and after 3 days, there he was grieving for the loss of yung his wife. And it is really a grief also for us as a church because, you know, yung wife niya is in the church, had been dear to many people. Okay. You know, life, a lot of times when we think that everything is going well, sometimes bigla na lang may mga dumadating. Bad things happen to us. And, you know, as we face all of this, now how do we deal with them? How do we find strength? I believe all of us have experienced something like this. Bigla na lang dumadating yung problema. Sometimes we don't expect it. Sometimes in the mid of celebration and something happened to us and we are devastated. But how do we find strength? How will we find the grace of God so that we would be able to deal with it. Today, I want to share with you from a passage in John chapter 2, verse 1 to 12. Okay, so let's read this passage and look at how do we deal with all of this in life. Okay, so let us read together. Okay. 2 days later, there was a wedding in the town of Cana in Galilee. Jesus' mother was there, and Jesus and his disciples had also been invited to the wedding. When the wine had given out, Jesus' mother said to him, "They are out of wine." Here, the Bible tells us 2 days later, there was a wedding in the town of Cana in Galilee. Okay, and so Jesus' mother was there, see Mary, as well as Jesus and his disciple was also invited in a wedding. Okay, I believe, you know, if you are in a wedding, it is really a celebrative day. Okay, everybody celebrate and everywhere are joyful. Okay, but the Bible said that when the wine had given up, it means to say that in the midst of yung celebration nila, biglang ano, naubos yung alak. You know, when wine runs out, how could you celebrate during the time? How can they celebrate without wine? Just like today, okay? How can we celebrate without food, di ba? Pag, you know, invite mo lahat kami. Okay, for example, si Daniel, okay, birthday niya. Ngayon, di ba? So, in-invite tayo ngayon lahat. Okay, and then we go there. And then when we are starting to eat, bigla na lang sabi, ay, naubos na yung pagkain. Ay, di nakakaya yan. And so this is what happened to this wedding. For this groom and bride, it is a really big things and embarrassing things. Okay, you know, things always happen in life. Okay, a lot of times, in the middle of all our celebration, okay, when things happen, it is really embarrassing. And I experienced that one thing last week. Ganun din. You know, when my son reception during the time yung reception. Okay, and so we were there, and a lot of people were coming. And bigla na lang may dumating sa akin. He came to me and said, "Pastor, yung one of our elder, okay, wala yung pangalan niya sa list because all are RSVP. So, alam mo kung sinong darating, and they have arranged all their seat. Nandun na kung sinong upo dun. And they have made it lahat, okay, para at least hindi sayang, di ba? Lahat nandun na. And so, he came to me and said, wala siya sa list. Saan siya uupo? And I said, ha? Wala na upuan, wala nang place for that. Sabi ko, paano yan? Because I miss this person. You know, before that, I asked kung he would be going. But during the time, sabi niya, tatanong pa niya sa misis niya. And so, I said, well, I'll get back to you. And I forget to ask kung darating siya o hindi. And so, dumating siya ngayon. And so, I said, paano yan? So, we make an arrangement. And at the end, we open another table. Okay, so at least para yung mga na-miss out or kaya hindi RSVP na dumating, so they would have a place to sit in there. And so, solve na problema. But for this wedding, no. Because when there is no more wine, you cannot go and buy it outside. Hindi ka, during the time of Jesus, you cannot just go. Walang 7-Eleven dun. Okay? Walang Arte Mart dun. And so you have to wait for maybe days or week before they would be able to bring your wine. Eh, paano naman yung mga guests na dumating, di ba? And so it is really a great disaster. You know, life, a lot of times, is like this. It is like a party. Okay? Just when you think that everything is fine and going well, suddenly, we run out of wine. You find ourselves laid off from mga trabaho natin. Sometimes we struggle with our finances. There's serious conflict in the family. Okay, your children got sick and maybe you have to be confined to the hospital or you heard some bad news and disturbing news about yung relatives natin sa Pilipinas. Okay, and many other things. It all come very sudden and it caught you off guard. You know, we don't expect it and dumating na lang. And so, for us, how do we face life when our wine run out? How do we face life when all the things that is happening right now is not good and then the midst of uncertainties, how do we find strength, how we be filled so that we would be able to face it? Today, I want to share with you 3 things that we could do. Whenever you find yourself just like in this family, na wala na yung alak, and then they are in big trouble, and how do they find solution and how do they face this itong problema to. Okay. Now the first thing that we realize when they run out of wine, di ba? In verse 3, okay, let's all read together. He said, when the wine had given out, Jesus' mother said to him, they are out of wine. So when they are out of wine, Mary, the mother of Jesus, came to Jesus. He looked for Jesus and he came and said, wala na silang alak. You know, when you look at this, why did Mary came to Jesus? Hindi naman siya yung host. Hindi naman siya yung nag-prepare ng wedding, isn't it? You know, he should go to the one in charge of the feast. Or he should go to the groom or to the bride to tell them na wala nang alak, paano yan? Diba? So that they would be able to deal with it. But Mary, the first thing he did is he went straight to Jesus and he told Jesus, they are out of wine. Now, why is it? Because Jesus knows one thing, that during this time that they are in a big trouble, it is only Jesus who could help them. Now, paano nalaman ni Jesus, ni Mary? Because Mary knows who Jesus is. You know, remember when Mary buntis siya, there was a angel came to him, and by the name of Gabriel, and he told Mary that the child would be called the Son of God. And then not only through the angels, when the baby is born, okay, dumating yung mga shepherd, and they started before the shepherd. You know, when he was pregnant, he went to yung relatives na Elizabeth. And so Elizabeth, yung relatives niya, prophesied about the baby that is inside him, that it is the Son of God. And when Jesus was born, shepherds came to give them yung message that comes from the angels about this child. And not only he heard it from the shepherds, he heard it also from Simon, who is in the temple, and also a prophetess by the name of Anna. Okay, if you look at all of this in the book of Luke, okay, all of this confirm about who Jesus is. And that's why Mary knows about who Jesus is, and he knows that it is only Jesus who could help, because he's the Son of God and nothing is impossible with him. That is why he came to Jesus. My brothers and sisters, a lot of times when we have problem, you know, Jesus is the last solution, di ba? Gagawin natin lahat ng bagay. And pag wala na, ano na, surrender na tayo sa Diyos. Lord, help me. That is the last resort. But for Mary, no. Alam niya na, you know, if he goes to the leaders of the feast, okay, the one that's in charge of the feast, or he went to the groom, walang mangyayari yan. And he knows that it is only Jesus who could help him. That is why he went to look for Jesus. May God help us. You know, whenever we experience any difficulties and problems, the only person that could be able to help us is Jesus. Why? Because he is the Son of God. And he is God, and in him, nothing is impossible. Okay, and the Bible said that, my God will supply all your needs according to his riches. In God's riches, every need that we have, yung grasya niya, is available for each one of us. And so that is why the first thing we need to go when we run out of wine is to go to Jesus for help. We need to go to him because it is he who could always only help us. There was a lady by the name of Annie Lobert. He was raised in a very abusive family. Okay. And so in order for her to sought yung validation or be praised, okay, feel niya yung pride niya, okay, and self-worth niya, okay. So he started to be in relationship with a lot of boys, okay. And however, you know, relationship with a lot of men, boys, okay, brings on a heartache and a lot of problem, betrayal. And so this led her to a very destructive path. And so he eventually turned into prostitution. Okay, now thinking that, believing that money and power, okay, would heal her wound, and that he would provide revenge sa mga tao that umapi sa kanya. Okay, even yung family niya. Okay, so one day she met a man who claimed to love him, to love her, and so okay, so he started to give herself to this man. Okay, but one day, okay, this man took him to Las Vegas only to reveal that he was a violent pimp pala, wherein he was trying to sell itong si Annie, okay, for prostitution. Okay, and so they was in Las Vegas, and she endured 16 years of abuse, violence, and degradation. So always, okay, this yung lover niya would always be looking for a lot of customers, and then he would be doing a lot of prostituting work. Okay, so one day he met one day, okay, as he came home, he know that he cannot leave itong lalaki na to, because if he leaves, he would leave everything. He would not have anything. Okay, no possession, no safety, and no hope. Okay, but one day when he came home, so her boyfriend asked for yung money that she had, that he had received from dalawang customer. But that day, she doesn't want to give to him. And that's why there's an argument wherein, you know, yung lover niya become violent. And together with yung mga kasama niya, they beat up si Annie. And so, Annie was really beaten very, very severe. And so, she was in the shower room, okay, after that. And she prayed to herself. He prayed to the Lord and said, "Jesus, please save me. I don't know if you are real, but I don't want to die." And he said to the Lord, and he prayed to the Lord. Okay. And so because of this prayer, God make him a way for her to recover from yung nangyari and even come to know the Lord Jesus. And through knowing God, encountering God, it ignites something in yung life niya. A vision. Okay. A vision, a purpose beyond yung pain niya. And what is it? She become what they called a virgin of Christ, because he experienced a new birth. Okay. And that lead her to help other mga women who had been trapped, in the same darkness. And he founded a foundation called Hookers for Jesus, an organization in helping itong mga tao, rescuing and supporting victims of sex trafficking. Okay. And her story become a beacon of hope to a lot of people. And through her work, not only he found healing, but he become a blessing to other people. So how does it happen when he started to realize that it is only Jesus who could help her? May God help us. You know, there are a lot of people that would be of our help. But then there would be time when in people will not be able to help us in any way. But Jesus can. And so whenever we go to Jesus for help, we will always experience something that is supernatural, something that would change our lives. Just like in this wedding, when they have this the wine run out, so Mary came to Jesus first and asked, and Jesus was able to help them deal with this problem. Okay, so the first thing we need to do is to go to Jesus for help. We need to go through. We should not wait until the last resort, but we need to go first in every way. Okay. Not only Jesus, Mary came to Jesus and asked for Jesus' help. Okay, now the second thing that we need to do when we run out of wine. Okay. In verse 4, when Mary came to Jesus and told him na wala na silang alak, this is what Jesus said in verse 4. Let's all be together. "You must not tell me what to do," Jesus replied. "My time has not yet come." And so when he was informed, Jesus said, "You know, you must not tell me what to do." Now, why did Jesus say this? Maybe, okay, the Bible did not say, maybe Mary, as a mother, di ba? Most of us who are mother, ganun tayo. Okay, if we see a problem with our children, ano ginagawa natin? Not only we tell them, but we tell them what to do. Dapat gawin mo ito, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then we try to force them to do according to what we want. So maybe Jesus was telling Jesus na, dapat mag-action ka na, dapat ano na, we don't know what he said. But, okay, from the answer of Jesus, we know that Mary was trying to dictate kung anong gagawin ni Jesus. That's why Jesus said to him, okay, "You must not to her, do not you must not tell me what to do. My time has not yet come." And so in these words, Mary learned something, that whenever God wants to do something, we should not give him the freedom to do it. Not only that, Jesus had his own way of doing things, but Jesus has his timing as well. You know, for us as Christian, a lot of times when we have problem, we come to Jesus and then we pray to Jesus. And then when we pray, sometimes we are frustrated. We said, "Hindi naman pinakinggan ng Diyos yung prayer ko." A lot of our prayers is what? It is not, "Lord, help me," but rather, "Lord, help me by doing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Di ba? Dinidictate natin sa Diyos kung ano yung gusto natin na gawin ng Diyos. And then when God did not do according to what we said, we will tell na, "Oh, God did not listen to my prayer. You know, wala, hindi totoo," or whatever it is, and we are frustrated with our prayer. But we need to always remember, you know, God has his way of doing things. God has his timing of doing things. God is never too late, and God is never too early. in solving, in helping us in our problems. And so if God has His timing, what do we do? We need to do one thing. We need to wait. We need to wait. And then not only to wait and to do whatever God wants us to do. That is why when Mary heard about this, what did Mary do? In verse 5, okay, let's all read together. Jesus' mother then told the servants, "Do whatever He tells you. The Jews have rules about ritual washing, and for this purpose, 6 stone water jars were there, each one large enough to hold between 20 and 30 gallons. Jesus said to the servants, 'Fill these jars with water.' They filled them to the brim." Okay. So, Jesus know about all this. He learned this. That is why He told the servants, sabi niya, no, do whatever it tells you. Okay. Anong gagawin? Hindi niya alam. But He said, whatever Jesus said, do what He tells you. And in verse 6, the Jews had rules about ritual washing. Ano itong ritual washing? It is when you come to a house, okay, you know, they wear sandals, isn't it? So madumi. So whenever they came in, they would wash their feet. So these are the 6 stone water jars that is there, that is used for washing mga feet. Okay. And so it one large enough to hold between 20 and 30 gallons. Okay. So Jesus said to the servant, "Fill this jar with waters, then fill them to the brim." And so this is what Jesus said to His servant, "Punuin niyo ng tubig." Okay? Because you know it had been used, yung mga dumating na guests, so it had been used up. So He said, "Fill it and then to the brim, punuin niyo." Okay? And so they did this. So here we see something about what we need to do. A lot of times, you know, when we are in need, we come to Jesus, we need to learn that He has His own way of doing things and His timing. And so what do we do? We learn one thing. As we seek His help, we need to wait until He works. Not to work on our own, but to wait until He do something. And whenever He started to do something, and He would tell us something, and we need to what? We need to follow what He is saying. So this is the second thing. Whenever we run out of wine, go to Jesus for help. The second thing, wait and do what Jesus said. Wait and do what Jesus said. Okay. Now, so this is something that we need to always learn, that God is in control. Not ours. We don't control God so that He do things according to what we need, but we allowed Him to do His work. Okay. Now, in a certain village, okay, there was lived a farmer by the name of Daniel. Ah, hindi na Daniel natin. So his name is Daniel. Okay. Now, his family tilled the land for generations. Kanila yung farm. Okay. So they were tilling for generations. Okay. So generation after generation, they were doing this. But recently, especially recent years, had brought hardship upon yung family nila. Bakit? Because the rain is very scarce. Walang masyadong tubig. And so just imagine, the whole plot of land, it becomes very, very dry. It cracks, and then it's hard to produce any mga crops. Okay. And so they started to worry about it. Not only they started to worry, the kids also started to worry. And then laughter sa bahay nila become less and less. Okay. And so the wife, Sarah, prayed to the Lord for rain. So she prayed and prayed, but nothing happened. So one day, Daniel went out to survey yung land. Okay. And then as he was looking all those land, he started to pray to the Lord and said, "Lord, what should I do? You know, I cannot do anything about this. I don't know ano yung solution. There's no rain. Then we cannot plant and there would be no crops. And, you know, we cannot live on this." And he continued to pray to the Lord. And as he was walking around praying, suddenly he heard something. There was a nudging, a prompting na, "You dig something. You dig a well dito sa gitna." And he said, "Imposible. How do I know na may tubig dyan, di ba? Okay, if I dig, pag wala, ay di sayang din." And so he dismissed it. But then every day when he was walking there, that prompting would come and said, "You dig on it. You make a well, you dig on it." And so he knows that it is what God has been speaking to him. And so what he did is started to dig, okay, through the land. Okay, dig a well. So when he was digging well, yung mga kapitbahay said, "Why do you do this? It is impossible now. When you dig a hole, meron na tubig dyan." Okay, so people laugh at him, they ridicule him, okay, they don't believe in him. But he continued because he heard something. He heard something that God has put in his heart. And so he continued to dig until one early morning, as he was digging, biglang lumabas yung tubig. Not only that the water is few, but it came up bubbling. And so when it come out, you know, it started to water all the field. And within a week, you know, the field become a very fertile mga land. And then they started to see a lot of mga crops started to come out of it. Okay. And all the mga neighbor was amazed. What? Ah, meron na tubig. And so they started to use this water in their land. And not for long, they were able to have a harvest. And they have this harvest, ano, yung mga kwan nila. They were, their crops were grapes. Okay. And then through these grapes, they were able to make wine out of it. And when they tested this wine, naiiba. Iba yung lasa. It is really very good. Okay. And so that is why they named this well Daniel's Vineyard. Okay, yung lugar na yun. To commemorate how God has made water came out, and then to water the land and then give them wine, okay, wherein they sell it. And it is a testimony of the work of God and the power of God. You know, if he did not do as Jesus told him, they will never have been able to find those water. And so all people was astonished and said, how did you know that Mary too big? Daniel told his wife, he said, I know the answer. It is because God told me, when I dig it, God put water in it. It is all the work of God. My brothers and sisters, a lot of times something that is impossible, but whenever we come to the Lord for help and wait and do what he says, we would always experience something that is beautiful, something that would be able to bring blessing upon us. Now this is what happened. So Jesus said, pour, okay, and then they followed. And as they obeyed what Jesus said, what happened? Okay, let us look at the Bible in verse 8. Okay, let's all read. And then he told them after pinuno nila yung jar. Okay, and then he told them, now draw some water out and take it to the man in charge of the feast. They took him the water, which now had turned into wine, and he tasted it. He did not know where this wine had come from, but of course, the servants who had drawn out the water knew. So he called the bridegroom. Okay. Anong sinabi niya sa bridegroom? And said to him, everyone else serves the best wine first, and after the guests have drunk a lot, he serves the ordinary wine. But you have kept the best wine until now. You have kept the best wine until now. And so he told, okay, mga servant, draw those mga water and then bring it to, okay, the man in charge of the feast, and then painom mo. You know, the water jar is for ano? For washing feet. And so if you are the servant, will you do it? Will you get the water and then bring it to the pakiinom nga? You know, it is hard, but they obeyed it. And because they followed after Jesus, something happened. They went there and they let this person taste. And what happened is the wine, okay, the water that become wine, is the best wine that he had tasted. More than the wine that has been given, okay, that been served in the first place. So here is something we see. You know, a lot of times God way over our mind or our reasoning. Hindi natin alam bakit ganun. But whenever we learn to trust in Him, whenever we learn to trust in Him for the outcome, alam natin na whenever God said something, God works, it will become what? It will come out the best. So we need to learn to trust that God has His best interest for us, that He will bring goodness, the best things in life for us. And so we trust Him, we obeyed Him, and we continue to do whatever He wants. And so the third thing, okay, that we need to do in order for us, okay, to experience God when our wine runs out, is to trust Jesus for the outcome. Not only we come for help, not only we wait and then to do what Jesus tells us to do, but we need to trust Jesus, knowing that whenever God works, He would always bring goodness to us. There was a certain brother in a Lutheran church. He was working in a certain company. Okay, he is a Christian. And then he had this prompting, okay, that God has put in his heart, okay, that the prompting to attend yung prayer meeting every week. Okay, and so he went there, he has this burden. So he went to this prayer meeting, to their church prayer meeting every week. okay, every week. No matter what, okay, he would left the office promptly on that particular day. So yung araw na yon, he would always promptly leave the office after office hour, and then to go to the church and to attend yung prayer meeting. Okay. One fateful day, his department manager confronted him. The manager said, "You need to stay past office hours, okay, and finish itong urgent work na kailangan tapusin." But the brother hesitated, said, "Boss, sorry, ah, because every this day, you know, there is a prayer meeting, and I have committed myself to God that I would attend. So I cannot stay. I need to go there. Okay, I promise you, kinabukasan, I will come early, and I'm going to finish this work." And so, okay, the boss was not happy about it. And so the boss said, the manager said, okay, he said, "You stay today, or else you face termination. I will terminate you." Not only it happened once, but many times. Okay, so galit na itong boss na to. Okay. And so the brother doesn't know what to do. He said, "Should I go to this prayer meeting that God has put a burden in me, or should I stay and work? Total, kinabukasan, I'm going to do it. Okay, I'm going to finish it before, okay, you need it, it would be finished." But then the manager insisted. So after praying to the Lord, you know, that prompting came and said, "You go and attend yung prayer meeting and leave the rest to me." And so this is what he did. He went to the prayer meeting, and after a few weeks, he was informed na he was fired from his work. And so he was confused and uncertain. He wondered why God allowed this to happen. You know, he put God first. Bakit nangyari sa buhay niya? And then baka mali yung decision, but it is what God has put in his heart. And so he continued to come before the Lord. But then as he was confused and was praying to the Lord and said, "Lord, bakit? There's that sound, okay, voice of God that tell him, trust me. You just trust me." Okay? And so he said, "Okay, Lord, I trust in you. So maybe you have planned for this. I trust in you for the outcome." Okay? So after that, he started to go and find another work. Okay? And God has been good because he landed on a new job. Okay, and he experienced God's blessing and favor. After a few years, he was able to promoted, okay, to a managerial position in that new company. Okay, and so he experienced the blessing of God. Okay, but the story doesn't end here. Okay, because the company that he worked for merged with another company. Okay, so it's very important acquisition. Binili nala yung isang company. And on the first day after the merger, when he went to the office, he discovered something astonishing. That his old boss, the one who had threatened yung job niya, was now placed under yung department niya. Because itong company, binili yung kabilya. And so he came here and he was under him. And he saw something that is astonishing. And he know that, you know, it is the work of God. Not only giving them yung good job, but he knows that God is in control. And the best, okay, is at the end. When he learned to trust in the Lord, God has his purpose, God has his way, and God has his plan. My brothers, sisters, may God help us. There are times when God wants us to do something which is for us unreasonable. Maybe we think that, oh, bakit ko gagawin yan? Kaagrabyado or whatever it is that we feel. But when we learn to trust Jesus for it, because we ask from Him, okay, we wait, He tell us something. And so when we trust Jesus for the outcome, we will be able to experience something that is better than what we have. And so may God help us. My brothers, sisters, as we celebrate our anniversary, maybe we are happy today. Maybe there are things in our mind right now, problems or difficulties that has come, and we are in the midst of these difficulties or circumstances that we have. So how do we face them? Remember, Jesus can turn water into wine. So what do we do is, well, first we go and to Jesus for help. We go to Him and ask Him to help us. Second, we need to wait for His work, not trying to convince God to do something according to yung gusto natin, but to wait and listen to what God would be saying. And when God speak to us, the third thing is trust God for the outcome, because the outcome would be better than what is in our mind. The Bible said that what God has prepared for those who love Him is eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, and mind has not thought about it, because our God is a great God. May God help us. So why not let us close our eyes right now? Okay, let us come before the Lord. You know, today we come to celebrate the goodness of God. And the goodness of God doesn't mean to say that there will be no problem, because we are living in a world wherein it is full of trouble. But in the midst of all this trouble and difficulties, we know that our God, He is a God that can turn water into wine. Not only any wine, but the best wine. And so no matter what kind of circumstances we find ourselves in, whenever we come to the Lord, whenever we learn to wait upon Him, whenever we come and trust Him for the outcome, we would always experience something that is better, because God never withhold good things from us, and He's going to do something supernatural for us because we are His son and daughters, and because we belong to Him. This is the goodness of God. Not that He would take away all our problems, but that in our struggle in life, He would always provide for us. So why not let us all stand up right now? Let us once again declare the goodness of God as we come to the Lord, and then to declare that, you know, all our life God has been faithful, and all of my life He has always been good to us. I love you, Lord. I love you, Lord. Oh, your mercy never fails me. All my days I've been held in your hands. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, I will sing of the goodness of... Once again, I love you, Lord. You, Lord, oh, your mercy never fails me. All my days I've been held in your hands. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, I will sing of the goodness of God all my life. All my life you have been faithful. He has always been good. All my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. I love your voice, of your voice. You have led me through the fire. In darkness night, you are close like no other. I've known you as a father, I've known you as a friend. I have lived in the goodness of God all my life. All my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. Your goodness, your goodness is running after, is running after me. Your goodness is running after, is running after me. And with my life laid down, I surrender now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running after, is running after. Once again, your goodness is running after me. Goodness is running after, is running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. With my life laid down, I surrender now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Oh, my life, you have been faithful. Oh, my life, you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness all my life. Oh, my life, you have been faithful. Oh, my life, you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. I will sing, and I will sing of the goodness of, once again I will sing, and I will sing of the goodness of God. Why don't we close our eyes right now? You know, God is always faithful to us because of His promise. He said that He will never leave us nor forsake us, especially in times of trouble. And He promised that He would make all things work together for good. And at the same time, He promised us that He will never withhold good things from us. My brothers and sisters, maybe we are going through difficult times we're in. What we see are not good in life. But believe me, God could turn water into wine. He could turn your life around. He could turn whatever circumstances that you are in right now, and He will come out good for you. He has a plan. And what do? We come to Him for help. We wait upon Him and ask Him and hear what He has to say to us. And at the same time, we learn to trust in Him for the outcome, knowing that it will be better than what we had thought of. And it will be supernatural in our lives. So why not let us take this time right now? Let us pray. Let us bring whatever that is in our hearts, our situation before the Lord. Let us tell Jesus, just like Mary said, Lord, they run out of wine. Maybe we need to come before the Lord and say, Lord, I run out of option right now. I run out of solution to my problem. I run out of patience. I run out of money and a lot of things. But whenever we come and seek Jesus' help, He would be always there for us. He is a very present help in times of our trouble. Why not let us come to Him this morning, knowing that He is here among us and He will hear us. Let us pray. Just pray to Him. Bring whatever that is in your heart right now and tell Him. Let us all pray together. Hallelujah, Lord. Oh, Shamanakara Shirubunikirika. Oh, yes, indeed, Lord Jesus, we come to You right now. Lord, we know that You are here among us, that You are God, Lord, who is Emmanuel. Lord, we know that You know whatever is happening in our lives. You know, Lord, the difficulty, the struggle that I have. You know, Lord, the heartache that I feel right now, Lord, because of these things. Lord, I'm helpless, and I feel very hopeless, Lord. Lord, I need You, Lord, and I know that it is only You who would help me, and that is why, Lord, I come to You right now. I come to You right now, Lord, and I pray, Lord, that You will come. Open my eyes, Lord. Lord, speak to me, Lord, and Lord, bring Your goodness upon me once again. Lord, I trust in You, Lord, because I know that in You, Lord, the outcome would be better than what I have thought of, and I know, Lord, that You would turn water into wine, and it is in Your hands, Lord, and I just come to You right now, Lord. As I bring to You, Lord, all that is happening right now in my life. Lord, I thank You and I pray to You, Lord. Yes, indeed, I come to You right now. And I thank You, Lord, Your goodness, Lord, in us. Hallelujah. Lord, as we come to you, Lord, this morning, we thank you and we praise you, Lord. For we know, Lord, that you are a God who could turn water into wine, who could turn around, Lord, whatever circumstances that we have right now. And we can expect, Lord, that the result will be better because of what you will do in our lives. Father, as we go through, Lord, this difficulty, struggle that we have right now, Lord, touch our heart so that we would be able to know that you are with us and that you know what is happening in our lives and that you are working, Lord. Father, we need you, for we know that it is only you who could help us and it is only you who could give us that strength. My brothers and sisters, I just want to pray for some of us who are going through difficult times. You have this doubt, you're confused, and you don't know what to do right now. But God knows. And you want to say, Lord, here I am. I commit my heart, my problems, my life into your hands. Show yourself that I would be able to feel you. Touch me right now. Is there anyone among us you need the touch of God so that you would be able to feel him, to know that he is with you and he will be doing something new? Will you please raise up your hand? Let me pray for you right now. Let me pray for you. Anyone? Yes, I've seen your hands. You could put them down. Yes, I've seen your hands. Yes, I've seen your hand. Anyone else? Yes, I've seen your hands. Anyone else? You said, Lord, I need you. I need you, Lord. I need your touch. Yes, I've seen your hands. You could put them down. Anyone else? You know, we come to the Lord raising our hands to tell Jesus that, Lord, we need your touch. So why not let us raise up your hands, Natim, and allow the Spirit of God to touch our hands, to feel the warmthness of his presence, and to come from our hands that we've entered into our body, and that we would be able to feel him right now. Let's come by faith knowing that God is here in our midst. Hallelujah. Oh yes, indeed. Lord, we come to you this morning. We need your touch, Lord. And we long for you to touch us, and that you will do it, Lord, this morning. But as we raise up our hands, we pray, Holy Spirit, that you will come. Touch our heart, Lord. Let us feel your warmthness that is come with among us. Let us know that, Lord, you are here and that you work and that you are doing something in our lives. Help us, Lord, that we would be able to learn to trust in you, Lord. Give us the faith that we will wait, that would listen, Lord, and that we will obey. As well as, Lord, we will trust you for the outcome, knowing, Lord, that you're doing something that is more greater, okay, than we have thought of, Lord. For all things work together for good for us, just like what you had promised. Right now, Holy Spirit, I pray, let your presence, Lord, come upon this place. Let your presence, Lord, come upon my brothers and sisters, Lord. Let their hands, Lord, be able to touch you, Lord, and to feel you right now in Jesus' name. We come to you by faith, knowing, Lord, that you are concerned with every one of us. You could put down your hands right now as we continue to pray. Father, Lord, you know every heart, and I pray that you will touch them this morning and that they will find, Lord, strength and confidence, knowing, Lord, that you are God who could turn water into wine. My brothers and sisters, God is a God who could turn water into wine. Not only that he could turn around whatever circumstances that you are going through, but he wants to stay in your life. He wants to be with you forever. And I don't know if you have ever make a decision and said, Lord, I want you to come into my life. I want to accept you, Lord, and invite you to come into my life and be my Lord and be my Savior. Is there anyone among us, you have never made this decision? You have never invited the Lord Jesus to come into your life to become your Lord and Savior. And this morning, you want to do this. Would you please raise up your hand, people that want to receive the Lord? This is your first time. You said, Lord, I want to invite you to come into my life and be my Lord and be my Savior. Is there anyone among us? Would you please raise up your hand? Let me pray for you. Let me ask the Lord right now that he will come upon you, that you will feel and then experience his salvation. Anyone else? Why not let us all raise up our hands once again? Let us pray and then follow after me as we pray. Lord Jesus, I thank you because you love me and you came for me. You died for me at the cross and then you have forgiven my life, my sin. And today, I want to invite you into my life and become my Savior and also my Lord, that I would be able to experience you all throughout my life and experience the salvation that comes from you. Touch me right now. In Jesus' name, amen. Father, we come to you, Lord. We thank you once again, knowing, Lord, that you have been good to us, Lord, and that you are always there for every season of our lives. And we know that you have been faithful, Lord, and that you have been good. And with every breath that we have, Lord, we just want, Lord, to declare your goodness right now. All my life, you have been faithful. All my life, you have been faithful. All my life, you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness. Once again, all my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness, and I will sing, and I will sing of the goodness. Once again, let's sing the goodness of God, and I will sing of the goodness of God. Let's pray. Indeed, Lord, as we come to you, Lord, we declared your goodness, your faithfulness, Lord, upon us, because you promised, Lord. And whatever you promise, Lord, you deliver. Today, Lord, as we stand in your presence, we just want, Lord, to praise you and to thank you, Lord. And at the same time, Lord, we continue, Lord, want to experience you, Lord, in our lives. And as we stand before you, may you bless each one of us. May the grace of our Lord Jesus, the love of the Father, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be upon each one of us until the day that Christ will come back and bring us into His glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. 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 Before you sit down, why not tell the person beside you, God has always been faithful to you. Okay, please take your seat. God bless you.
Okay, so we would like to welcome everyone. Okay, it's nice to see new faces and also old faces. Not old because of your age, but because we have seen you before. We welcome you and hope that you can join us not only for today but every Sunday. Okay, but every Sunday, hindi kami 10 nag-umpisa. Okay, so alas 9, we start our worship service. So be here and join us. We also have a prayer meeting. Okay, so if you're in need na special needs na kailangan, okay, you can come and join us Wednesday nights, okay, 8:15 p.m. And of course, if you have further question, kasi ngayon you have no opportunity to ask or to clarify, okay, may cell group kami sa Fridays and Sundays. Okay, if you want more details, ask the person who invited you to come. Okay, and we would like to invite you to remain with us, have lunch with us. Okay, and in the afternoon, wala tayong yung traditional dice game. Okay, instead, we will have a total body exam. We will test your brain, we will test your eyes, we will test your logic, we will test your reading comprehension, and we will test your body coordination. Pero hindi kami doktor kaya walang certificate. Ha? Okay, just if you want to be tested and have fun, remain this afternoon after lunch. Okay, we will give you time to rest. Picture. Kanta muna, di na kanta? Mas importante yung picture. Kanta mo. Okay, so let's sing our welcome song. And after the song, please do not leave this place. Sarado yung pinto. We will have our own, we will have our picture taking to remind everyone nandito tayo. Okay, so let's sing our song first. Welcome to the family. Welcome to the family. We're glad that you have come to share your life with us. As we grow in love, and may we always be to you what God would have us be. A family always there to be strong and to lean on. May we learn to love each other more with each new day. May words of love be on our lips in everything we say. May a spirit melt our hearts and teach us how to pray. That we might be a true family. Okay, let's go around and welcome each other in the family.